Apollo 11, over.
Go ahead, 11.
Roger, we're working on the pressurization of the LEM now and working off the decal of CSM LEM pressure equalization. And we're down to step 13 where we're waiting for the cabin pressure to be 5, or it should be roughly 5 before we turn the repressed package O2 valve to fill. Instead of 5, we're running about 4.4, over.
Roger, stand by a second.
said Apollo 11, we did put the repress package O2 valve to fill momentarily there in step 13, and we have filled the bottles back up partially. What's the pressure reading there now, Neil? Now we have about 450 PSI now in the 3 1-pound bottles.
Roger, stand by a second, please.
Roger, standing by, and the repress package valve is now in the off position. What's the cabin pressure now, please? Cabin pressure is now 4.5.
At 3 hours 46 minutes, velocity is 18,917 feet per second. Distance from Earth, 9,002 nautical miles.
Apollo 11, we think these readings are within normal tolerances. We just wanted to get your concurrence before we pressed on any further with the decal.
Okay, Captain.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. Go ahead.
Roger. LM looks to be in pretty fine shape. About all we can see from here.
Okay, in reference to your question on this step 13 on the decal, I understand that you have used up the contents of the repress O2 package, and at that time, instead of being up to 5 PSI, you were reading 4.4, is that correct?
Okay, 4.4, yes, sir.
Okay, and you want to know if you can go ahead and use additional oxygen to bring the command module up to 5.0 and continue the equalization, over?
Yeah, we think it's within normal tolerances, Bruce. We just wanted to get your concurrence before we pressed on with this procedure.
Roger, Apollo 11, go ahead.
Okay, we're pressing on with the procedure.
And 11, Houston, we have a request for you. On the service module secondary propellant fuel pressurization valves, as a precautionary measure, we'd like you to momentarily cycle the four switches to the closed position and then release. As you know, we have no TM or talkback on these valve positions, and it's conceivable that one of them might also have been moved into a different position by the shock of separation. Over.
Okay, good idea. That's being done.
Houston, roger out. Apollo 11, Houston, we're doing a non-propulsive event on the booster at the present time. You may see some sort of a cloud coming out of it, and when you're ready, I have your evasive maneuver pad.
Roger, it's coming out.
Roger out.
It's a haze that's going by toward our minus X direction, and several small particles are moving along with it. The actual velocity is fairly high. At least it appears to be high. And we've got a O2 high, flow high right now.
Houston, roger out.
Houston, you might be interested that out my left-hand window right now, I can observe the entire continent of North America, Alaska, over the pole, down to the Yucatan Peninsula, Cuba, northern part of South America, and then I run out of window.
Roger, we copy.
That was Neil Armstrong with that report.
Houston, Apollo 11, all 12 latches are locked.
Roger, 11, this is Houston. Understand, 12 latches locked.
That was Buzz Aldrin reporting that all 12 of the latches in the docking mechanism had locked.
Houston, whenever you're possessed of a free moment there, we've got this evasive maneuver pad.
Go ahead, Houston. Apollo 11, ready to copy.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. Evasive maneuver, SPS GNN, 63481, plus 095 minus 020 GETI 004 40 0100 plus 00051 plus all balls plus 00190 roll is your option. Pitch 213 357. Noun 44 is NA. Delta VT 00197 003 00152. The rest of the pad is NA. No ullage. LEM weight 33290. Read back over. Apollo 11, this is Houston, standing by for your read back, over. A11 Houston, do you read? Over. Apollo 11, this is Houston. Do you read? Over.
Oh, all of a sudden there, we had a little click, and the signal strength began to start dropping off. Your transmissions were cut off very abruptly. How do you read now?
Roger, loud and clear. We had a handover to Madrid about the time I was, I guess, halfway through the pad. If you could give me the last value you read, I'll pick up there. Over.
Okay, start with Delta VZ. Over.
Roger, Delta VZ is plus 00190. Roll, your option. Pitch, 213357. And noun 44 is NA. Delta VT, 00197. 003, 00152. The rest of the pad is NA. And no ullage. LEM weight, 33290. Read back over.
Roger, Houston, evasive maneuver, SPS, GNN. 63481, plus 095, minus 020. 00440, 0100, plus 00051, plus all zeros, plus 00190. Roll, crew option. 213357 NA 00197 003 00152 No ullage. LEM weight 33290. Over.
11, this is Houston. Read back correct out.
That's Apollo Control at 4 hours, 4 minutes. Apollo 11's velocity now is 17,014 feet per second. Its distance from Earth, 11,753 nautical miles. We're about 5 minutes away from ejection of the lunar module, and about 35 minutes away from this evasive maneuver. The ignition time on the evasive maneuver, an elapsed time of 4 hours, 40 minutes, 1 second. It will be a service propulsion system burn of 3 seconds duration, delta V 19.7 feet per second.
Yeah, Houston, Apollo 11.
Go ahead, 11.
We'd like to arm our logic switches.
All right, go ahead with the logic.
Okay, Mark, logic 1 and 2 armed.
Roger, we show the logic arm and your go for pyro arm.
Houston, we're ready for LEM ejection.
Roger, you're go for LEM ejection.
Thank you. Houston, we are set. We have a cryo press light.
Roger, copy cryo press light. Roger 11, we recommend you turn the O2 fans on manually and ensure that the O2 heaters are in the automatic position.
Roger, O2 heaters are on and we're going to cycle the O2 fans now.
Roger, O2 heaters to auto, or you can watch them in the on position, and O2 fans manual on.
Thank you.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Houston, Apollo 11.
Roger, in reference to your question on RCS usage, it looks like you're about 18, maybe 20 pounds below nominal at the present time. No problem at all, over.
Right. Want to be 18, 20 pounds above nominal, babe.
Sorry about that.
This is Apollo Control at 4 hours 34 minutes. Apollo 11's velocity is 14,972 feet per second. Its distance from Earth is 15,895 nautical miles. Spacecraft weight, 96,760.9 pounds. We're about 5 minutes away from the evasive maneuver that will ensure there will be no problems of recontact between the spacecraft and the S-IVB stage of the launch vehicle.
Houston, your systems are looking good. We're standing by for the burn.
The duration of this burn will be 3 seconds. Delta V 19.7 feet per second. Ignition. Shut down.
Houston, Apollo 11, could you confirm that pitch gimbal motor number one turned off? We just shut all four off and we got a questionable indication on the ECS on pitch one.
Roger, stand by a second. This is Houston. Stand by, please.
Go ahead, Houston. You copy our residuals?
Rector, we got 0-0 and 0.2, it looks like.
We had 0.1 while ago. It just went to 0.2.
Okay.
And EMF Delta V counter is minus 4.0.
Minus 4.0, roger.
And how about pitch gimbal one? Can you confirm that off?
Can you stand by just a second on that? At the present time, we cannot confirm it off. We saw a current drop indicating that several gimbal motors had gone off. We'll be back with you in just a second on it. Over.
Okay. If necessary, we can recycle it.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. If you go ahead and cycle pitch gimbal motor number one on and then off and give us a mark, and we'll tell you what we see. Over.
Okay, fine. It's coming back on. Ready? Mark. It's going back off. Ready? Mark. And that time we got an onboard indication, Houston. Thank you a lot.
Roger, we confirm that it is off.
Yeah, we do likewise.
This is Apollo Control at 4 hours, 44 minutes. A news conference at the Kennedy Space Center is about to begin. We will take down the live circuits and tape air to ground during this news conference, play it back after the conference. This is Mission Control, Houston. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 5 hours, 11 minutes into the mission. The S-IVB slingshot maneuver was completed about 5 minutes ago, designed to put the third stage of the launch vehicle into a trajectory that will take it behind the trailing edge of the moon and then into a solar orbit. The crew did not witness this maneuver. The command module was not in the proper attitude where they could see the S-IVB at the time. We've advised the crew that we do not believe that we'll do the first mid-course correction, that we'll wait for mid-course correction 2 tomorrow and expect a delta V to be performed in that maneuver of about 21.3 feet per second. We've also had some other brief transmissions, including a comments from Neil Armstrong on the view out the window and a weather report on the part of the world he can see. We have the tape of these transmissions that have occurred during the news conference at the Cape. We'll play that for you now and catch up live.
Houston, Apollo 11, we're starting our maneuver to observe the S-IVB slingshot.
Roger, 11, we've got an updated attitude for you on the slingshot observation.
Okay, say the angles, please.
Roger, roll 002.5, pitch 289.3, yaw 357.5. And there's also an update, minor correction to your attitude for the P-52. Over.
Roger, I have roll 2.5, pitch 289.3, and yaw 357.5. Over.
Roger. And for your P-52 and optics calibration, it'll be roll 346.5, pitch 345.0, yaw 007.8, over.
Roger, 346.5,
345.0, and 7.8,
thank you. Houston, roger out.
Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Roger, go ahead, Houston, Apollo 11.
Roger, we're going to go ahead and enable the S-IVB for the slingshot maneuver. The lock dump will start about 12 minutes from now, over.
Okay, lock dump about, I guess that'll make it about 01.
All right, I'll try to give you a little closer update as we approach it.
Alrighty.
And 11, for your information, the magnitude of mid-course correction number one, if we burned it, looks like about 1.7 feet per second. We're presently considering not burning it. This would make mid-course correction two tomorrow about 21.3, over.
That sounds good to us.
Roger, you're looking good down here.
Yeah, we didn't have much time, Houston, to talk to you about our views out the window when we were preparing for limb ejection, but up to that time we had the entire northern part of the lighted hemisphere visible, including North America, the North Atlantic, and Europe and Northern Africa. We could see that the weather was good all just about everywhere. There was one cyclonic depression in northern Canada and the Athabasca, probably east of Athabasca area. Greenland was clear, and it appeared to be we were seeing just the ice cap in Greenland. All North Atlantic was pretty good, and Europe and Northern Africa seemed to be clear. Most of the United States was clear. There was a low, looked like a front stretching from the center of the country up across north of the Great Lakes and into Newfoundland.
Roger, we copy.
I didn't know what I was looking at, but I sure did like it.
Okay. I guess the view must be pretty good from up there. We show you just roughly somewhere around 19,000 miles out now.
I didn't have much outside my window.
Yeah, we'll get you into PTC one of these days and take turns looking.
Alright,
well.
Houston Apollo 11, we've completed our maneuver to observe the slingshot attitude, but we don't see anything. No Earth and no S-IVB.
Roger, stand by. In GET, I have a lock stop start time for you. It's supposed to start at 5 plus 03 plus 07. And stop at 5 plus 04 plus 55. LH burn starts at 5 plus 37 plus 47. Stops at 5 plus 42 plus 27. Over.
Roger, thank you.
11, Houston.
Go ahead, right. Houston.
Roger, we now recommend the following attitude. Roll 307.0, pitch 354.0, yaw 019.5, and the lock stump has already been enabled, so we can't hold it off any longer.
That's okay, go ahead. We'll maneuver around to 307, 354, and 19.5. Thank you.
Roger. 11, Houston. It doesn't look to us like you'll be able to make it around to this observation attitude in 2 minutes. We recommend that you save the fuel, over.
Okay, Houston, you got to us just a little late. Our maneuver has already begun, so it's going to cost us about the same amount of fuel to stop it, no matter where we stop it in. We may as well keep going.
Roger, go ahead. 11, Houston, lock stump initiated. 11, Houston, lock stump has been terminated, over.
Roger. We still don't have the site.
Roger out. Apollo 11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead.
Roger, if you'll give us accept and stay in poo, we'll set your trunnion bias to zero, and I have a plan for balancing your oxygen cryos, over.
You got it.
Roger.
Now, Houston, Apollo 11, we've got the, what appears to be the S-4B in sight, I'll estimate a couple miles away. It's at a number 5 window. And the delta appears to be coming out of two radially opposite directions from the S-4B.
Roger. They're continuing with a non-propulsive vent from the liquid oxygen tank. It would be radially opposite there. And boosters tells me that it's the continuous vent system. They're also dumping a small amount of fuel at this time. You've got about 23 and a half minutes or so until the apps burn. Over.
Roger.
11 Houston, we have a recommended configuration for your cryo switches to even up the load between oxygen tanks 1 and 2. Over. Okay, you're coming in very weakly there. We're recommending O2 tank 1 heater off, O2 tank 2 a heater to auto, O2 tanks 1 and 2 fans both off. H2 tank 1 heaters to auto, and H2 tank 2 heaters to off. Over.
Roger, we have that, except the last one was H2 fans to off. Is that a problem?
H2.
We have, the configuration we have now is hydrogen heaters. We got 1 auto, 2 off, oxygen heaters. 1 off, 2 auto, and we have all the fans off.
This is Houston. Roger, we concur. 11, this is Houston. We've completed the Trunnion zero bias setting. You can retrieve the computer and go to block.
Roger that, thank you.
11, this is Houston. We're just maneuvering to observe the slingshot. I guess we missed copying your LEM-CM Delta P reading, over.
Stand by, we'll give you a reading.
Roger.
Right now reading 0.2, Bruce.
Roger, 0.2. Okay, Mike, and could you verify that your waste compartment valve was in vent there?
Roger, waste compartment valve has been in vent for, I guess 45 minutes or so.
Roger, we copy.
If we're late in answering you, it's because we're munching sandwiches.
Roger, I wish I could do the same here.
Don't leave the console.
Don't worry, I won't.
Flight doesn't like it. How is flight today?
Oh, he's doing quite well.
This is Apollo Control at 5 hours 22 minutes. We're back live now. The Delta P you heard discussed is the difference in pressure between the LEM and the command module, cabin pressure. Apollo 11 coming up on 22,000 miles distance from the Earth now. Velocity 12,914 feet per second.
Houston 11.
Go ahead, 11.
Down the control center, you might want to join us in wishing Dr. George Miller a happy birthday.
Roger, we're standing by for your birthday greeting.
I think today is also the birthday of California, and I believe they're 200 years old. We send them a happy birthday, and I think it's Dr. Miller's birthday also, and I don't think he's that old.
Roger, we copy. I'm looking back in the viewing room right now. I don't see him back.
He may not be back from the Cape yet.
Roger, I believe Dr. Miller's on his way back from the Cape. We'll relay his greetings for you.
Thank you.
11, this is Houston, over.
Go ahead, Houston.
Roger, at your convenience, we'd like to get a wastewater dump to 25% remaining. After completion of this one, the next wastewater dump will be at about GET equal to 25 hours, over.
Coming on right now.
Roger.
This is Apollo Control at 5 hours 31 minutes into the mission. Apollo 11's velocity now 12,637 feet per second. Distance from Earth 22,971 miles. Spacecraft weight 96,573 pounds.
Houston, Apollo 11, you copy our torquing angles?
Roger, leave them on there for another second, please.
Will do.
This is Houston. We copy the angles, but stand by before you go ahead and use them. Over.
Standing by.
11 Houston, we request that you redo P-52, and if the angles come out the same magnitude, go ahead and incorporate them. Over.
Okay, we'll do that.
They look a little large right now.
Yeah, roll looks a little large, especially.
Roger. We're showing a wastewater quantity of about 13% on TM now, 11. Over.
Roger, it's off now.
Roger, we copy.
Houston, Apollo 11, torquing angles essentially the same, and we're going to go ahead and torque them now.
Roger, we concur. Apollo 11, this is Houston. Could you give us an auto optics check to a third star or a different star from the one you've been using?
Sure, be glad to. I can go back and do the whole thing and pick different stars.
No, I don't think there's any need to do that. We'd just like to confirm it with a different star since that roll angle was a little larger than we expected.
Okay.
C-11 Houston, I have a TLI plus 11 hour pad when you're ready to copy.
Wait one. Well, star number 30 looks like it's right dab smack in the middle of the section.
Houston, roger out.
Ready to copy.
Roger, 11. This is a TLI plus 11 hour P-37 format. 0-1-3-4-4. 4-7-9-3. Minus 1-6-5. 0-4-9-2-3. Read back over.
Roger, 1-3-4-4, 4-7-9-3, minus 1-6-5, 0-4-9-2-3, over.
This is Houston, read back correct out. Thank you.
This is Apollo Control at 5 hours 55 minutes. Apollo 11's velocity 11,970 feet per second. Distance from Earth 25,671 nautical miles.
Houston, Apollo 11.
Go ahead, 11.
Roger, do you have any update for the roll, pitch, and yaw angles on the top of page 37 in the flight plan, or are they still good?
That's for the optics calibration?
Yes, sir.
Yes, indeed. I'll give them to you in just a second here. For the optics calibration, I've got 346.5 for roll, 345.0 for pitch, and 007.8 for yaw. The pen and ink attitude corrections in your book for P23 are good. Over.
Okay, thank you.
And we're going to hand over to Hawaii in about 5 or 6 seconds here. We'll have a momentary comm dropout.
Roger.